Stem Cell and Brain Research Institute in Lyon is a unit of INSERM, France's National Medical Research Institute. The SBRI performs multidisciplinary fundamental research along the axis from stem cells to brain, with an important focus on what features of stem cells, brain development, and brain function are specific to human and non-human primates. Here we provide some examples of the groundbreaking work at SBRI. Chloe grows pluripotent embryonic stem cells from chimpanzees in work that contributes to the effort to understand the genetic mechanisms controlling stem cell renewal in the early primate embryo. Irene is injecting chimpanzee pluripotent stem cells into rabbit embryos to study their potential for multiplication and differentiation in the embryonic environment. This work could lead to a better understanding of human embryonic development and make it possible to create animal models of human brain diseases. Camilla is changing media and imaging cerebral organoids. These organoids can recapitulate major steps of the development of the cerebral cortex. Building organoids from stem cells of patients with specific mutations or disease should permit us to explore how their cortical development has been impacted. Véronique is filming fluorescent cortical progenitors and newborn neurons in green with two-photon microscopy to analyze their behavior over a couple of weeks. Studying organotypic slices of primate developing cortex allows us to identify the mechanisms of development that are specific to primates. Dorothée is tracking the behavior of the cells to characterize the cellular mechanisms of primate corticogenesis under normal and pathological conditions. We also study how cells can be reprogrammed for different functions. Marie-Madeleine is placing fresh neural tissue in culture. Her aim will be to reprogram astrocytes into functional GABAergic neurons in vitro using retrovirus. To follow the fate conversion of her cells, she combines transcriptomics with bioimaging to try and unravel the molecular mechanisms underlying this process. This direct lineage reprogramming is an innovative approach to brain repair. It could allow the use of endogenous cells to create lost neurons in an injured or diseased brain area. Antonin is staining different parts of the retina and then using laser capture microdissection to collect retinal samples. He's trying to understand how the different layers interact in their response to light for the regulation of circadian rhythms. Circadian rhythmicity is significantly controlled by light detected in the retina. A better understanding of how light on the retina affects our rhythmic functions is crucial because circadian rhythms impact many molecular, cellular, and cognitive functions in virtually all living organisms. Yuji is building an atlas of the non-human primate cortex based on its cellular composition and the connectivity between brain areas. This critical anatomical work links detailed cellular anatomy to our understanding of the brain as a complex system, showing how the anatomy of the cortex subserves specific functions in a hierarchical framework. Clemence is performing histological analysis of a specific interaction between two frontal regions of the brain, studying specific cells that connect those regions and that have been tagged with the retrograde viral technique. Her aim is to understand how modulation of the activity in this specific cortical interaction impacts cognition. Clément is making neurophysiological recordings of single cells and cell assemblies from the same two regions of the frontal cortex of a non-human primate. This work seeks to understand the mechanisms of this cortical interaction in real time. Such cortical interactions are altered in a range of psychiatric conditions. Understanding how they function normally is an important step to understanding disease. Kim is using functional neuroimaging in an MRI scanner using human participants. Her work links visual perception to the cortical anatomy revealed by the anatomical work in the lab, showing how our fundamental research in cellular and animal models can be directly applied to knowledge about humans and eventually to human disease. The multidisciplinary research of the SBRI, from stem cells to brain, is providing rich fundamental scientific knowledge about cell and brain systems. This knowledge will be crucial if we are to make progress in understanding and treating medical conditions implicating those systems.